Well, the Lord certainly leads one in an interesting direction. And after praying this morning and getting on with the day as best as possible, I was made aware of a need for a council position to sit on the University of New England Council, of which I was a graduate of that university. So this morning I typed a four-page document, and I sent it off to them expressing my interest in standing for the council. This is not about me. It's not about myself wanting to seek eye adultery. It's not about me wanting to big note myself. It is about just having the opportunity to be able to stand up for those students that are on the autism spectrum, or those that are wanting to go to university and find it difficult. As you probably know, in the past I approached the University of New England about the graduate walk to see if the university would be obliging to make a donation or allow me to have an honorary, you know, tablet brick in the pavement, and they didn't follow up on that. So again, I thought by God's calling that I would apply for this position. Now, I have traversed to Armidale. I've travelled to Armidale, and if I have to, I'm prepared to go down there once or twice a year if it needs to be to sit on the council, which of course involves a big commitment because it's a 6-hour drive from Brisbane to Armidale. But I really want to make an input and provide a voice for those on the autism spectrum that are really wanting to have an opportunity to go to university and to have the supports necessary to support them. Having worked in the university setting, in the library setting, and having studied at the University of New England, I know both institutions quite well. And as you know, that I will be speaking at the University of Queensland on the 1st of May about my experiences as being an adult on the autism spectrum. I really want to break down the barriers that exist in our world, that exist with people not understanding autism. I'm tired of just not being understood. I'm tired of really being on the outer of the community. And this is a perfect opportunity, by God's grace as well, to be able to serve within that academic environment. The applications close this Friday, the 15th of March. They close in a bit of time anyway. I've sent my application off early. So it's going to be there well and truly before the close date. And I have made contact with the representative concerned, and I've asked for him to give me a call back. So I've done all I can. So it's just a matter of moving on to the next step. And I've been reading this morning. I wanted to just read a piece from, as I try to learn the Bible every day, I find that it's hard to get young people to study the Bible with, so I just teach myself, I read it, and I go through, I allow God to guide me through. I just wanted to read a passage that was actually a passage that was quoted yesterday. And in the Bible reading I had with a counsellor, She read the passage, and it comes from Joshua 1:9. And the Bible says, "Have I not commanded you, be strong and of good courage? Do not be afraid nor dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." And Joshua commanded the officers of the people, saying, "Pass through the camp and command the people, saying, prepare provisions for your people, saying, prepare your provisions, for within days you will come over this Jordan to go in to possess the land which the Lord your God is giving you to possess." So just with those very words from Joshua, it's the Lord has given me the means to go forward with strength in the challenges that lie ahead. I know that I'm not really understood by young people. I know that I'm rejected by young people. I know that even young Christians I contact, I don't ever receive a response or reply. And often, you know, often there is always this frustration with what's happening, what's going on, what can be done. So I've done what I can today. I put forward that application and just a matter of moving forward from there. Thank you very much for watching, and may God bless you.